be able to achieve that goal of number one faster than what is planned. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, Sri Anand Stanley, for sharing with us the industry perspective. And then it would not be wrong for us to say that the best of the civil aviation industry in India is yet to come. Moving ahead, ladies and gentlemen, the moment that we all have been waiting for, may I request our Honorable Chief Guest, Sri K.T. Ramarao Gowda.
Honorable Minister from Puducherry, Sri Malladi Krishna Rao Garu, Arvind Singh Ji, the Chairman of Airport Authority of India, Srimati Ushapadi, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Civil Aviation, Sangeeta Reddy Garu, Chairperson of FICCI, Sri Anand Stanley, MD of Airbus and also Chairperson of FICCI's Aviation Council. Firstly, I would like to thank all of you. In fact, not only the dignitaries on the dais, but also all of you, as Srimati Ushapadi pointed out, all of you who were this show, this largest aviation show in Asia. In spite of what has been happening around, in spite of all the news and all the, I would also like to add, misinformation that's going on in several social media platforms, I think it takes a lot to organize an event like this and also to show up and make it a huge success. So I think all of you deserve a huge, big round of applause for yourself. Thank you very much for being in Hyderabad. Thank you very much for making this happen. I'd also like to thank Honorable Minister for Civil Aviation, Sri Hardeep Singh Puri Ji, who's graciously consented for this event to be hosted in Hyderabad. And equally thankful to Honorable Prime Minister and Government of India for giving us this opportunity to host this event in our city of Hyderabad. All these events actually give us an opportunity to showcase our state and capital city to the aviation industry players from all over the world, and also to showcase our most vibrant aviation ecosystem, the Indian aviation ecosystem, to dignitaries from across the world. There was every reason, in fact, to screening was done. I'm sure all of you went through that. And then there were abundant supply of sanitizers, made sure that, you know, we were all, you know, I read the joke recently from someone, I think it was yesterday or day before, and this is purely purely a joke, please don't distort this, I request my friends from media. Now, somebody sent me a WhatsApp message yesterday saying, you know, my hands have seen more alcohol in the last 4 days than my liver has seen in the last 40 years. So just a joke, just a joke, please. Please don't distort it. Please don't make me look bad. But let me extend, like I said, my sincere gratitude and thank you for all the to all the officials who've done a stellar job in making sure that this event has begun and begun very, very successfully, even under the current circumstances. As was pointed out by Anand and also Arvindji, Indian civil aviation ecosystem and also defense aviation ecosystem has just taken off, literally. In fact, I think the growth prospects, the amazing trajectory that we are going to transcend in the next decade or so, is all out there for all of us to witness and for all the corporates here to latch on to. Telangana, in fact, within the Indian states, among all the Indian states, Telangana is the fastest growing state in India, recording 14.9% GSDP growth in 2018-19. We stood on top of the World Bank's ease of doing business rankings for 2 years in a row. Our state's industrial policy, called as the TSIPAS, is rated among one of the best in the country. Our capital city, the city that we all take a lot of pride in, Hyderabad, has been consistently ranked as a city with the best quality of living among Indian cities for 5 years in a row by Mercer. It's a cosmopolitan city offering the best infrastructure and pleasant weather almost throughout the year. Aviation and aerospace is a thrust sector for our government. And during the last edition of Wings 2018, Telangana also won the Best State Award from Government of India for the state with the most progressive outlook in this sector. You may recall, those of you who have attended the event last year, that we are among the first states taking the advice of Union Government to slash the VAT, the value-added tax on ATF, from 16% to 1%, setting an example for all other states in the country. This decision has given significant boost to the regional airline industry, prompting leading operators such as SpiceJet and IndiGo to expand their operational base in our city, Hyderabad. Our primary airport, the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad, is consistently awarded best in its class. It recently won the awards for the best regional airport and the best airport staff service in the Skytrax World Airport Awards in 2019. In line with the theme of the event, Flying for All, we are now planning to reactivate old airports and airstrips, create greenfield airports, and also establish a chain of heliports to connect the remotest parts of our state. We have proposed 3 greenfield airports and revival of 3 brownfield airports in the state of Telangana. The 3 new greenfield airports that we have proposed to Ministry of Civil Aviation are at Bhadradri Kottagudem, at Zakranpalli in Nizamabad, at Gudibanda village at Adakal Mandal in Mehboobnagar. And the 3 brownfield airports that we plan on reviving, one at Mamnur village in Warangal, Basant Nagar in Peddapalli, and Adilabad at Adilabad district. The state government has appointed AAI as consultant for preparing the techno-feasibility studies for existing airstrips and feasibility studies for greenfield airports as well. We're actively working with various stakeholders to make the Warangal airport functional as soon as possible. It will boost regional airport air transport and also support the various other initiatives in our Warangal district, such as Mega Textile Park, which is India's largest textile park, and also the Information Technology Hub, which has been launched recently and has been gaining traction. We've requested Ministry of Civil Aviation to include Warangal Airport under the Regional Connectivity Scheme, the RCS Udan Scheme, and I do believe that with the help of Government of India, we'll make it a very successful airport as well. Warangal also falls within the concession zone of 150 kilometers agreed with Hyderabad International Airport, and the airport land is under the custody of Airport Authority of India. With blessings of Ministry of Civil Aviation, all stakeholders have agreed to work together to operationalize this airport soon with an operating model similar, possibly to be the airport model. As was mentioned by Anand, there's a huge opportunity also for MROs, maintenance, repair and overhaul, in Hyderabad, in Telangana. We see this as a great opportunity for investment and high-value employment creation and aspire to be a hub for airline and engine MRO activities. We have requested Government of India already to reconsider their decision on GST with respect to MROs, and we have received, in principle, a positive response. The state currently has 2 functional MROs operated by GMR and Air India. We are in active discussions, like I said, with various OEMs and operators, and we are told that the ecosystem in the state offers best infrastructure and skill base to further our ideas. Telangana is also the first state to come out with its own drone policy to develop an ecosystem for the drone UAV industry. The state government is actively working with startups and industry partners to pilot drone use cases in healthcare, agriculture, mining, law enforcement, etc. In fact, with the World Economic Forum, we've also launched, and with Apollo Hospitals, we've also launched a project called as the Medicine from the Sky, which we are very upbeat and proud of. I would also like to thank Ministry of Civil Aviation for the excellent support we have received so far and request fast-track permissions for our various pilots and training initiatives with respect to drones and their usage. Telangana also made massive growth in aerospace sector in the past 5 years. Hyderabad has emerged as the most preferred aerospace manufacturing destination in India for global OEMs. Leading aerospace majors such as Sikorsky, Lockheed Martin, Boeing, GE, Safran, Rafael, Elbit, etc. have established their mega manufacturing facilities in Hyderabad. And I'm sure, Anand being a Hyderabadi, there would be a point when Airbus also, I'm sure, would consider Hyderabad to set up a large base here as well. Amongst all the leading players, the Tata Group does more than 90% of their aerospace manufacturing from Hyderabad. Adani Group and Kalyani Group are also expanding rapidly their aerospace and allied projects in Telangana. We also have a strong local industry, private industry, with over 25 large OEMs and more than 1,000 MSMEs, many of them who have already integrated their supply chain with the large OEMs across the world. Today we have 5 dedicated aerospace parks, over 50 general engineering parks in Telangana, catering to the precision engineering industry. We have 5 parks, like I said, one at Adibatla, Nadargul, the GMR Aerospace Park, the Adani Aerospace Park, and we also have 2 hardware parks where precision engineering also is given a huge priority. Our various electronics manufacturing clusters and technology SEZs also host a large number of small and medium aerospace firms. The biggest strength of Hyderabad aerospace ecosystem is the availability of large, highly skilled and other industry-ready workforce. To make world-class skilling accessible at affordable rates, we have partnered with global institutions. Today, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University of the US, Cranfield University of UK, and AeroCampus Aquitaine of France offer need-based aerospace certification courses in Hyderabad at relatively affordable costs. The state-run skilling agency called as the Telangana Academy of Skill and Knowledge also runs various job-oriented aerospace skilling programs. The government is also now planning to establish a world-class aerospace university in Telangana in partnership with industry and also global universities. As was pointed out by Anand, yesterday we even launched a new pilot training program with flight simulators of FSTC in Hyderabad Airport Complex. We also have established several new age institutions to encourage innovation and support the startup ecosystem. T-Hub, which is India's largest technology incubator, and T-Works, which is India's largest hardware incubator slash prototyping facility, have come up in Hyderabad and are expected to facilitate more homegrown aerospace hardware startups. T-Hub has already partnered with aviation majors such as Boeing, Pratt & Whitney and Collins Aerospace to accelerate startups in aviation and aerospace sector. In a short span of time, Telangana surely has emerged as the most exciting and well-supported aviation and aerospace ecosystem in India. Once again, I'd like to thank the Ministry of Civil Aviation for choosing Hyderabad as the recurring state for the biennial Wings Air Show and Global Aviation. I thank the officials of central and state government departments, health, importantly, the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, fire, traffic, airports, customs and CISF, and all other departments whose committed partnership has made this event possible today. Once again, welcome you all to this wonderful city of Hyderabad and look forward to supporting the growth of aviation and aerospace sector in the state and in our country. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing with us such exciting news of how, from boosting of regional airports to manufacturing to skill development, there's so much happening in the city. I think the fact that we all are here is because we lead by your commitment. Thank you for that. Ladies and gentlemen, moving ahead, may I now request Srimati Sangeeta Reddy to propose the vote of thanks and for her closing remarks.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and namaste. As will become a global greeting from now on, just being safe, we all do the namastes. It is indeed a great pleasure on behalf of FICCI to propose the vote of thanks, the formal vote of thanks. The leadership on the dais, Sri K.T. Ramarao Garu, Krishna Rao Garu, Sri Arvind Singh, Anand Stanley, definite mention to the dynamic Ms. Usha Padi. Also, many of you in the audience who have played a major role in putting this conference together, I definitely would like to acknowledge the role of Mr. Jayesh Ranjan. I was asked to go into the Union Minister's office, Mr. Hardeep Singh Puriji, and he said, are you sure you want to continue this conference? And Usha Padi was on the line, and Jayesh Karu said, I have spoken to all our leadership in the state. We are committed to go ahead. So I think we must thank and commend the state government for finding the fine balance between driving the economic engine of the country while also taking care of the safety of the people. And this fine balance was in the form of, number one, the public display, which is normally very well, you know, appreciated, has been cancelled. And therefore, all the tremendous exhibitors who are here, over 110 exhibitors, I request the electronic media, please showcase the wonderful exhibitors and the air show so that people can enjoy them in the new way of the world, which is watch television, because they are not able to be here. So I want to, at the same time, as thanking the state and the central government for going ahead with this program. I'd really like to thank the exhibitors, over 110 exhibitors, 600 business delegates and 20 states who are here participating, showing not just their dynamism and their commitment to the sector, but also your excitement about the future, which has, you know, beautifully been expressed by the Honorable Minister, Sri KT Ramarao, and of course Anand Stanley gave you this overview. India will not just be number one because of our high traffic, our manufacturing capacity, our ability to now move into the MEA and the repair side, but also I think of special mention is the Prime Minister's move towards the Udan. Now we can visit places like Hampi, which took 6 hours of driving and a lot of commitment on those bumpy roads in a 20-minute flight. So India has been committed, has been connected like never before, creating a new economic engine. And I think this move continuing, whether it's Warangal or more locations in the northeast, this will not only boost tourism but also the economic engine of those particular states. And the 21st century is really an era about connectivity where physical distances are no longer relevant. Technological innovations can make that change. And so I'd also like to mention of the multiple international delegates who had to postpone or cancel their trips to India, the video connectivity, the ability to teleconference, to be part of this program, let the dialogues and the business continue in the new way, in the new era. Let no aspect of the business discussions be in any way slowed down because they could not physically be here. As you all know, who will survive in the future? It's not the largest, it's not the biggest, it's not even the smartest, it's the most adaptable. And that's really what we are doing today. We are adapting to this new scenario while continuing to progress. So I thank everyone who was participating, everyone who's made this possible, the FICCI Secretariat, the state government teams, the health department, the GHMC, every single individual who's made this possible, and of course the dynamic ministry and the union ministry. Our chairman of the airport authorities, you represent such a large team and so much, and your ability to swing into action. So actually we thank you not just for the conference, but on behalf of the people of India and the world for the ability for the airports to quickly put in screening, do the containment. And ultimately as a healthcare person myself, I must say that we must not be scared or anxious about the coronavirus, but we should definitely be smart and cautious. And therefore, the ability to follow safety precautions. India, I hope, will show an example to the world in our ability to flatten the curve. If we allow this linear growth of numbers to continue, it will definitely be a major crisis, which will affect the safety, the health, and the economic engine of the country. So let's flatten the curve by following these protocols, being safe, containing those who are having a problem, following social distancing or home quarantine for those who need to, and by and large following the effective protocols of the WHO and the very dynamic Ministry of Health of the Government of India and the state. So with this, once again, let me thank you on behalf of FICCI, wish all of you a wonderful conference. Especially thank the electronic media for making sure that everyone who could not attend the conference feels the power and the energy which is in this room and feels the potential of the future of this sector. All the very best to all of you. Namaste and thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Ladies and gentlemen, with that, we come to the end of the inaugural ceremony. I would now request our Honorable Chief Guest and other dignitaries to kindly step out and move towards the static display. Following that, we would also request you all to have a visit to the Ministry of Civil Aviation, Charlotte. And then we will have a very exciting air show by Sanan team and Mark Jeffrey team. Sure to take your breath away. And following that, we would request you all to kindly join us for the inauguration of the exhibition. At 12:30, we all reassemble back in this hall for our first panel discussion, Capacity Building Airlines and Airports. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your support for the inaugural session. We look forward to seeing you back for a panel discussion. Right now, inviting you all for the static display. And thank you to our Honorable Chief Guests and other dignitaries for being a part of the inaugural ceremony.
We'll quickly take a moment for a group picture for all our media.